What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. We are hanging out in the garage. So much work to be done. The first garage vlog, the first real garage vlog of the 2021 season. We have so much work to do. Not really the old man's car, but mostly my car. His car is pretty much ready to go. There's not much gonna be changing on his car, but my car, tons of work, tons of things that we need to get done before we're even close to race ready. I wanna run through all of it with you guys today and hopefully get a little start on some of these projects, so stay tuned.
Start it up.
So if you guys recall from previous videos, I've actually had the front half of this car completely rebuilt. Towards the end of last season, we noticed a whole bunch of cracks, like at least a half a dozen cracks developing on the front half of this car. So we went ahead and just had the whole front half of the car rebuilt. The whole front half of the car is brand new. The only difference is that it does not have like the ports in the actual tubes to run like cables or wires inside of the chassis tubes. Rumor has it that NHRA is potentially gonna start like outlawing that. I don't know if there's any truth to that. That's just like something I've heard, that they're starting to go away from that. They're gonna start not making that legal. So, I mean, the back half of my car has a whole bunch of it anyways, but the front half of the car, we just said, no ports, no ports. So the challenge for us is that we actually have to kind of rewire the front half of the car. So all of the wiring that was done inside of the actual chassis, we have to kind of like pull that out. I pulled it out halfway before we went and had the front half chopped off so we weren't chopping off the wires. But what we need to do is pull all of that wiring out and then rewire everything external since there's no ports on the front half of the car. It's basically just safety. I mean, you guys, I had a half dozen cracks in the front of this car. It was absolutely terrifying. I don't need any extra holes. I don't need that. I don't need that in my life.
Guys, just a quick rundown of what we actually accomplished today. Honestly, I don't feel like I accomplished that much today, mostly just because me and the old man haven't spent a lot of time together lately, so we spent a lot of the day just talking about racing and just all of our plans and all of that kind of stuff. You guys know how it goes, I'm sure. We were able to get a few minor things done. I put a little list together of all the things I want to accomplish on this race car this off season. So I'll quick give you a rundown right now. So starting from the front to the back, one thing that I really wanted was some new headlights. So I was able to actually accomplish that today. Shout out to Mike at Punisher Racing. Mike is actually a Lucas Oil dealer. So Lucas Oil products at Punisher Racing, they actually provided me with these awesome, awesome headlights. They turned out super good. Really impressed with these headlights, the build construction and stuff. I mean, I haven't had the opportunity to turn them on yet, but really impressed with them so far. I decided to mount them in a little bit different way. You see the old ones, I still have the bracket here. They were up on top here. These headlights actually sat a little taller and it just looked too weird. They were just like big old bug eyes on the front of this thing. So decided to mount them down here. So as you can see, I actually had to mount them through the body, drilled a hole through there, got rid of the whole Zeus spring mounting system. But what was kind of cool is that the Zeus hole was actually able to be used for the cord. So that actually turned out pretty good. I think they look pretty awesome. Really excited about not having those really, really shabby looking headlights this year. These actually look nice. Moving back, you can see that I actually accomplished a lot in this area of the car in the regard to wiring, moving all of that wiring up here to the front, but I didn't actually button everything up completely because I am not 100% sure what kind of battery I want to put in this car this season. Looking for your guys' recommendations down in the comments. Looking at either going with a single 16 volt standard battery or potentially the lithium batteries. I've been looking pretty hard at them. I'm not sure what I want to do, but I will tell you that two heavy red top batteries, 12 volts, are not going back in this car because that's what's always been in here, but we're gonna change that up this year. Haven't finished up all of this wiring just because I'm on the fence of what I wanna do right there. Moving on to the back in this empty engine compartment, we're gonna be dropping in not the 565 I had last year, the 582 Headhunter. We have this baby all ready to go. This thing has been freshened. If you guys are wondering who does all of our engine work, well, it's the old man. You know, it's the old man. He does all of the engine work. He builds everything pretty much and gets it ready to go. This is the 582. This is actually the biggest engine that we have. The other two engines we have are 565s. This is the one I ran last year. So we have a steel 565. This is the one I ran last year. Then we have another 565 that has an aluminum block, so it's way lighter. And then we have this 582. So the 582 and the aluminum 565 are the two best pieces, and they run very comparable. This is the one gonna be going in my car this year, just because this is the one that we have sitting fresh. The one that's in my dad's car only has a half a season on it. And that girl right there has got two seasons on her, so it's her turn to be freshened up this year. This thing is pretty much ready to drop in the car, so definitely hit the subscribe button if you are interested in watching us put it in the car. We have a few odds and ends to clean up here too, but we're going to be putting an alternator on this year, so getting that to fit will probably be a little bit of a challenge. Also, the oil pan is a little bit different on this one, so it kind of requires us to have a weird starter, plus it looks like my dipstick tube is not going to work, so I'm going to have to get a new one of those. You know, all the little details. When you have one part that's different, then everything's got to change. We're trying to keep these things as standard as we can, but can't always get it. On top of that 582, you guys know it's that K&R Performance, all American made, all billet aluminum, piece of beauty. Gonna be bolted up onto the top. Super excited to see how this thing performs. And we have all the fittings, this awesome billet fuel rail, everything. We already had it on the shelf. It's good to go. It's gonna fit. I can't believe that was a huge plus that happened today, that all of those fittings, we're not missing anything. Normally we have to order a bunch of stuff.
Not today.
Moving on back to the transmission. Of course, this is a Power Glide put together by Long Motorsports Performance Transmissions over at Dale's A1 Transmission. And I am not actually sure if we're going to be freshening this or not. But honestly, if I ever have any questions about transmissions, I know who to call. It's going to be the boys over at Dale's A1. Whatever they recommend as far as freshening up this Power Glide, that's what we'll go ahead and do. So we'll just see what Devin says, and that's what we'll end up doing. Of course, we'll have to get the Jones cooling system on. Jones transmission cooling systems, keeping that Power Glide cool. That worked so awesome. Links down in the description if you want a video more about this. Of course, we're gonna be getting some fresh sticky Mickeys on the back of these Extreme Fab bead locks. I think Mickey Thompson, part number 3195. Those are the big Bubbas. Had a lot of a great experience with those last year. So we'll be getting another set of them to throw on them beautiful extremefab.com. That's where it's at if you guys need conversion beadlocks. Woo! And at the way back, you'll see we got the axles tore out of this girl. They're sitting over here on the bench. We're gonna be replacing the axles because if you guys remember from a video middle of last season, I believe we broke an axle, so we had to borrow some axles. These actually aren't ours. We gotta return these. We gotta put in different axles, so we just had to dig them out so we could get the measurements and get them on order. What else? Oh, Pro Stage. We're gonna be installing a Pro Stage. Oh man, crazy story about the Pro Stage. I actually got it in the middle of last season. Towards the end of the season, I was installing it, and as I was installing it, that is when we noticed all of the cracks. So I have like three quarters of that video shot already, and it just never got completed. So we're gonna be putting a pro stage on. So K&R Performance Engineering video coming soon about that. So that's pretty much all of the plans that I have for the 2021 off season. I don't think I've forgotten anything. We have a lot of work to do. So that is pretty much all of the future video content on this channel. If you're interested in watching that, make sure you click the subscribe button so you don't miss when I upload a video. Definitely hit the like button on this video if you enjoyed it. Visit the GallStar TV swag shop to support the creation of more videos just like this one. And I will see you guys in the next video. Later.
Oh boy, what are you? I cannot remember what you are. Oh, this must be the, yeah, this is the on-off switch for the, so I still have to wire the on-off switch back to the battery. So this will just go to the battery for the turning the air compressor on and off. That's what that is. Yeah.